Today we are reading Bao's Adventure in Space. It was a hot day in Interleville. The friends were exploring the cool and shady woods nearby. Bao had heard something interesting. He led the way, running, and the others followed. This is Bao, and these are his friends. They entered a wide clearing. In the middle was a large, shiny spaceship, and sitting beside it were aliens. See, these are the aliens. There were two of them. They both had large green heads and four arms each. 1, 2, 3, 4. The aliens looked at them and waved. They said, "Hi." "I am Kao," said one alien. "This is my friend Pao." Beaming, the friends introduced themselves to the pair. "What a lovely planet you have." They sounded very friendly and not scary at all. "Please, Mr. Kao," said Bao. "Could we have a ride in your spaceship?" The alien smiled. "Sure," said Kao, and the door of the spaceship slid open. That's not very nice. We cannot talk to strangers and definitely cannot go along the strangers. The spaceship was large and there were strange buttons everywhere. Bao gaped in wonder. "There are many things to see in space," said Kao. "Where would you like to go?"
"I always wanted to see the planet Mercury," said Ella excitedly.
"Well then, off we go." Bao pressed some buttons and whoosh, they were off to space. The spaceship started flying towards the sun. Soon they were so close to it, they had to cover their eyes with their hands. Suddenly Bao announced, "Here's Mercury." Ella peeped from the between her fingers for a second. She caught light of small planet very close to the sun. "It's too bright," moaned Ella, covering her eyes again. "Let's turn back." Bao turned the ship around and the friends could open their eyes again. "Whew, let's go to Venus," said Mick. "I heard it's nice and warm there."
"That's easy," said Ka.
"Venus is the next planet. Hold on." Again, they zoomed off. They flew close to the planet that was about the size of the Earth. It had many volcanoes, spouting red, hot lava high into the air. "That's Venus," said Kao, and Mick's face fell. He liked hot places, but this was too hot, even for him. "Oh no," he said sadly. "Never mind, Kao, let's go somewhere else." Binky's favorite planet was Mars. "It has so many sandy holes, as seen in pictures," she said excitedly. "I bet there are burrows of alien rabbits. Please, could we go and see it?" Pono wondered. Mars was a bit further away on the other side of Earth. The kids could hardly wait. "Finally," Po said, "we have reached Mars." The friends looked around cautiously. It was red, sandy, as Binky had said, but it was empty. They flew on and on over it, but saw no one. Binky was disappointed. "Oh well, let's leave this place." "Don't worry," said Eddie. "I'm super sure Jupiter will be great fun. It's too big to be completely empty." "Let's go and see," replied Kao. Eddie knew Jupiter was big, but he didn't know how big. As they got closer, they saw that it was many times bigger than Earth. Eddie gasped. "It would take years and years to see even a bit of it. And he had school tomorrow. Maybe we should leave Jupiter for later," he said finally. "Let's go to Bao's planet." Bao rubbed his hands excitedly. His favorite planet was Saturn. "It always reminded me of a huge spinning frisbee with its rings," he said. Sure enough, when they got closer to Saturn, they saw it was huge, though not as huge as Jupiter. It also had many beautiful rings around it. The children were excited as they began to enter the planet. For a long time, they passed only clouds. After a while, Bao asked, "Aren't we going to land?" "Land?" said Bao, surprised. "Saturn has no land to land on." "Just like Jupiter, no land," Bao was crestfallen. He had been looking forward to a nice run to stretch his legs. "Let's leave," he said, glooming.
Maybe the other planets will be better. Back in space, the ship was now speeding towards Uranus and Neptune. These are two planets at the last in the solar system, said Kao. But I don't think you'll like them very much. Poor old Uranus and Neptune were so far from the sun, they were all cold and blue. Let's just go home, groaned Bob. Po turned back towards the Earth. It was getting late and the kids had to drop back home. The aliens dropped the friends off at Interleville and waved goodbye. Now that their holiday was over, they had to go back home to their own planet far away. Oh, we forgot to tell you which your favorite planet is, said Cow and Pow as they waved. It's Earth. That's why we came here. Bye. The children smiled and waved back. You know, Bob, said the Bob, once the spaceship had gone, I think my favorite planet is Earth too, the others agreed. It wasn't too bright, or too hot, or too cold, or too big. It was just right. The end.